Frank and Maddie Jones had a vision in 1959 to create businesses to stand the test of time. In 2022, This Is It remains a staple in the Houston community. How do they survive going forward with a fifth generation? Chapter 4, Building Generational Wealth.
Soul food to me is having everyone come around the table on Sunday, getting together after church and just being thankful for what you all have done throughout that week. Just sitting down, being relaxed, you know, just everyone's calm, no one's attitude, everyone's just happy right now.
I truly just think that soul food is food that makes you feel loved from someone else. So something that somebody takes the time to make special for you, not like from the freezer, not picking something up, but something that they're proud of and they want to share with you. And so the reason I gave that preface was because I have a really good friend, Ami, who has told me like, well, Jessica, this is Indian soul food. And the first time I heard that, I was all like, soul food doesn't have to be so confined to just the Black community. And when I said that out loud one time on a news interview, I was like attacked by the community, right? But I still stand by what I said. Soul food is just food that makes a connection and love between 1, 2, 3, 300,000 million, gazillion people. It's food that provides love.
Going to This Is It when they moved to the second location with my family on Sundays. This is before I even knew who the family was, but yeah, just going there for the oxtails and just the atmosphere, you know, like you're at home.
Every time I see there's a picture in our office that's under our TV with Mr. Craig and Mr. Jones, and I just look at it and I'm just amazed of what he started and the legacy that he's, you know, that he's allowed me to be in essentially in some point, you know, to carry it on. And, you know, I'm just, every time I look at it, I'm just thankful. And if I could see him today, I probably cry, to be honest with you, man, because he's paved the way for me to have a sustainable life, for me to work for a sustainable life. From word of mouth, I actually just come into the restaurant, you know, just looking for jobs. I mean, because they come in hungry. And that's something that we wanted. This Is It. We want people to have good work experience, but to be hungry about it, you know, and treat This Is It like it's theirs. And, you know, I find that people that do come in and walk in, those are the best people to hire because, you know, they're about business. You know, their money means something to them and the business means something to them.
So when I came in, I thought it was going to be just, you know, walk in, pick up and keep going with whatever there is. But because I hadn't been involved in This Is It in all these years and just watching from the outside, sort of, I didn't realize all the complications and the frustrations and any shins you can think of. I just couldn't think of them. And I would have never thought of them if I hadn't stepped in. With getting a closer look at all the work my parents have put into This Is It, all the work that my grandmother put into This Is It, then my great-grandparents, seeing customers, talking with family, friends. There's something in me that's been ignited to where I can't just sit by and let whatever happened to This Is It, be it great or be it not so great. I can't not be a part of it. So growing up, I never said, I want to work at This Is It in the sense of like long-term. Starting off, my parents had me, Chris and Junior at the restaurant working, you know, like bussing tables, fixing drinks. When we got a little bit older, we could do the register. So, you know, things here and there. And of course, whatever we had to do, we had to be good at it. So we made sure we were really good at it. But I wasn't doing it because I just had some strong desire to keep this going for forever. I actually had no career interest at all. When I was 15, I made it very clear to everyone that I would like to be a wife, a mom, and a community member. End of story. And by community member, I meant being involved in my community, supporting schools, supporting local programs, but all at my own will, not by force of a job. However, I'm practical and I knew that that doesn't just happen overnight. So I went to school and I have a thing with pressure from people around me. So I lied and said I was gonna be a pharmacist so nobody would question me about being undecided. And ultimately I decided I wanted to be a teacher when I was in my room that night. And so I had my foot in the door in that sense of being involved from a distance, right? Not necessarily saying, hi, I'm Jessica Joseph and I work at This Is It Soul Food. But it was, hi, I'm Jessica Joseph, daughter of Craig and Georgette Joseph who own This Is It Soul Food. And I left it at that for a long time until I got with my husband and he kept putting this bug in my ear, you know, like, how can you not do anything with the restaurant? And I'm like, I don't want to. The restaurant is not going to provide the family goals that I want. I grew up with my daddy always gone. Now, and I say always loosely. Of course, he was at things to support us, but it was either mama was there or daddy was there. It wasn't, I didn't have enough memories of both of them there, even for trips. It was like we went with mama or we didn't trip at all, you know? And so I didn't want to have to make decisions like that. But the older I got, for some reason, I just kept having this internal discussion with myself of, are you really gonna let Chris have to do This Is It all by himself? Junior's so busy with Mickey's. How is he gonna have time to help work with Chris? Who is gonna be Chris's helpmate? You know, what if he doesn't marry somebody who's into the restaurant? Daddy had mama. Like, are you really gonna abandon your brothers like this? And so I stepped into the restaurant like full throttle, probably more than anybody wanted me to do, particularly my brother, who I was just trying to help. Like, we didn't have our first fallout until we worked at This Is It. We grew up our whole lives, regular bickering, but no fallout. And I was all in, but it was definitely a level of stress that was not healthy for someone whose dreams was to be a wife, a mom, a community member. But thankfully, I married somebody who, even before I decided, was already putting that bug in my ear of like, how can you not be involved in your family's restaurant? Like, y'all own This Is It. Like, that's such a big deal. I grew up in it. I knew it was a big deal, but outside looking in, you know, it's a different way to see it. And ultimately, though I was the first one to step in out of me and Thad then came on, who actually has a much stronger passion for the food industry in regards to working at running a restaurant. And so I've taken a step back from that, and I'm actually going back to my teacher roots, and I'm now teaching culinary arts, teaching foods for today, and teaching hospitality instead of having to be in the food and restaurant industries.
With Craig Jr. running Mickey's Soul Food, it seems as though continuing the legacy of This Is It will rest squarely on Chris's shoulders. It doesn't. Thaddeus's drive for the food business proves to be immeasurable.
Thaddeus was maybe 3, and my mother was in town visiting, and we came to the restaurant to eat. And mom was eating a ham hock. And he asked my mother, who could never tell him no for anything, Mimi, what's that you're eating? And she told him, Thaddeus, that's a ham hock, and this is so good. And he was like, do I like ham hocks? And she was like, I don't know, baby, do you? And he ate it, and he ate her whole ham hock.
I want to say it was the end of 2016, early 2017. I just had a nagging feeling, and I guess you could say it's God fate, or however you want to call it, that I just felt like God was just pulling me like, hey, get involved with the restaurant, get involved with the cafe. This is meant for you. You should be a part of this. Go ahead. This is what I called you to do. And I had a tough time dealing with it, man. I was working with a a medical company at the time, and it's a pretty good job, you know. I had some hiccups in the road, but you know, all the more, it was a really good job, and that's one of the reasons why I was like, I just don't know if I can. But God, you know, put it on my heart and compelled that, hey, start getting involved with the restaurant, you know, even take baby steps and I will guide you. And that's what happened. I started up, my first steps was starting to cook in the cafe on Saturdays and Sundays with my father-in-law. He taught me the ropes. I've been doing that for about 3 or 4 years now, and I love it. And wouldn't trade it for anything else right now.
There's the story of my brother who would come to Houston to visit, and I had been telling him about This Is It, and my family is a family that we love chitlins. So he would get his chitlin fix while he was here, but he would always take chitlins back to Tampa. And one trip, we forgot to get them ahead of time and freeze them. So we picked him up from the restaurant on the way to take him to the airport. And his story is when he landed, and of course that was back when you can take food on the plane. His story was when he landed, everybody was trying to figure out what that smell was.
One of the most frustrating ones for me is our staff. I've always been known as the happy-go-lucky, super optimistic, find the bright side in everything. And to be surrounded with a staff not like me, that was tough. Every day I had to go in and convince employees to be happy. Now, these are the employees that I came in working with. Now, some of them had happy, like, you know, dispositions here and there. But then at other times, it was just unfriendly.
Well, one of my first memories is the mean old woman they used to have back there who used to talk crazy to you if you didn't know what you wanted, you didn't know how you wanted it. But over the years, things have gotten better. It's so laid back now. People are nice and friendly. And basically, I just remember that older lady. And I think her daughter's in that now. I'm not sure, but yeah, she was something else.
You want to say her name?
I have no idea what her name is.
Wait, really?
No, I never knew her name because I wouldn't mess with her. I'm serious. Because I was so, you know, I was intimidated by, as big as I am, I was intimidated by, and if I knew, if she told me something, I was gonna go off on her, so I just kind of laid back and let her do her thing.
Once I stepped in, I even had to push the limits with my own brother as far as attitudes go. And some people were with it, and some people were against it.
When I first started, my attitude wasn't that great, because I saw it as just a job. I didn't see this as my livelihood. And now that I've been working here for so long and seeing the attitudes I saw back then to now, it's been a big, big change. And as far as the employees, getting rid of some bad employees we had that had bad attitudes back then, now it's been a major change, and we actually made a big progress through it. Yeah, I realized I needed to make a change when my mom told me that, you know, this is what you have to live off of. If your attitude isn't going to be good, the customers won't come in. As long as you're being happy and thankful for what you have, then you will be blessed on the other end. So therefore, I had to change my attitude. I used to come in mad, come in, you know, frustrated, just because I had to come to work, not knowing that coming to work is taking care of what I have at home. And so I had to be thankful for that now. It's like now I realize I have a family, so this is what I have to come in and be thankful for and be happy for every day.
Some had to get fired. Some left on their own. Some changed. But overall, I feel like with the time and efforts that myself and my brother and my husband are putting into selecting staff as we move forward with this transition onto us, it's getting now a consistent vibe of greatness instead of a consistent vibe of average. People are nicer. People are nicer on purpose. People are held accountable when they aren't as nice.
History repeats itself. Although Craig and Georgette trust their children with business decisions, they question their kids' business involvement on social media.
You know, with social media,
makes it so hard because people are so critical of everything that happens. And I've seen, not only for us, but other restaurants, I mean, they take one little thing that happens and blow it up into this huge thing where you have hundreds and hundreds of people that are talking about it and ragging on your business and, in essence, destroying your character, you know. And a great deal of them have never even been to the establishment, but they have an opinion. Everybody has an opinion and they want to share it publicly. You know, we've always had an open door policy. I have a customer who, if he comes in, you know, and say somebody wasn't as friendly as he thought they should have been, he'll privately send me a message and say, this person, you know, I don't know if he's new, maybe he needs some more training, you know, you might need to talk to him. And I do, and it gets fixed, you know, and I appreciate that type of criticism. And I think if more of us were willing to do that for each other, you know, as opposed to just trying to tear down each other, we would have a lot more Black successful businesses of all types.
No family is perfect by any means, but the strides that I've seen, you know, us make, you know, just from a relationship level, you know, it shows a testament to who we are, because we're fighters. I mean, every single last one of them, every single last one of us, rather, you know, it might get tough, but we ended up sticking together and, you know, fighting through it and, you know, obviously coming together to get the job done. And I think at the end of the day, I think that that's what family is really all about.
The family attempts to sort out their business affairs. Then the unthinkable happens. Natural disasters nearly derail their efforts.
It went two different ways. The pandemic, obviously we had to close down for precautionary measures, but after we opened back up, that was around the same time as the George Floyd movement and the Black Lives Matter movement. So we began to see an increase in the amount of business that we normally even would have before COVID. So I feel like that just compacted a lot of stuff on us, and we were able to still come out and thrive and be successful with the support of the community. But now, as far as the freeze, we did have to take care of some things in-house. We had a couple pipes burst and we shut down for maybe a week, but that wasn't nothing too serious.
Craig Sr. continues to build upon that legacy with the help from Chris, that is, and Jessica. Their collaboration is a steady business model for the fifth generation. At that point, This Is It will have nearly 80 years behind them.
We don't want to just give This Is It away. We don't want to just say like, oh, 60 years, you know, it's been a good running, let's just cut it off now. No, we're like, well, hey, can we do something? Can we start something ourselves? Can we make this be a part of our own? Can we put our own stamp on the history of This Is It? And the moment we get that true blessing and support with the risk that we're willing to take, you know, me and my brother, we have our own families, and, you know, that's a big deal. And then my oldest brother, you know, he has his success with his business, and I've watched him take risk. And as far as I'm concerned, how do they say it? Big risks, big payoff, something like that, you know? Hey, can I at least take like a medium-sized risk, a medium-sized payoff? I believe in us. There's been plenty of times, and I think this probably comes with anybody who has a business, where you just want to say, forget it. Like, for what? Why? No way. This, just give me a regular job where I can just be done, go home and stop thinking about work and just enjoy my free time. That's all fine and dandy, but I can remember back when, I think it was Brother Draper at my parents' church, he did a message about like building a legacy. I don't remember like the exact title, but It was all centered around legacies and generational wealth and being able to do something meaningful that you could pass on to the generations after you. And when I heard it, I didn't just hear it as wealth as far as like finances, but I also heard it as like wealth in terms of knowledge, wealth in terms of love, wealth in terms of appreciation and hard work, wealth that exceeds all expectations. And I've been given that, thankfully, by both of my parents. And that came to them from my great-grandparents, which was a blessing.
This Is It is the oldest soul food restaurant in Houston. And to have survived all these years is nothing short but a miracle. You know, even Sheila Jackson Lee, you know, has said that she feels like This Is It should be designated as a historical landmark. I don't know if the move, because a lot of times from what my understanding is, to be a historical landmark, you have to be in the same place, the same location. And so I don't know what the move from 4th Ward to 3rd Ward, if that's impacted the viability of that ever happening or not. But is it a landmark? Yes, I believe it is. My children have truly grown up in it. They've been working at This Is It since they could sit on a stool. I see the love that they have for the restaurant, just like their father has, and it makes me proud. I hope that they can, you know, continue to run this business for another 60 years.
In the next 60 years, I actually see it expanding. I mean, me and my brother-in-law are working hard to get this thing to be a whole lot more than what it is when my dad made it to be. We want this to be so well-found and so well-known that our kids won't even be able to believe. We want to franchise out and have everyone just knowing that they started from nothing and now we came here.
Hey, I'm willing to do whatever it takes. I'm willing to do whatever it takes as a family to keep this stuff going, because I hate to think about it, but one day dad will be gone, just like his grandparents, and he made them happy. We want to make him happy. And he looked down on us and see, look, them boys and my baby is still keeping this business going. We want the goal that it get to babysitting in little Chris and stuff. Again, I'm willing to do whatever it takes here at the restaurant. They know I'll do whatever they ask me to do. I don't care nothing about it. I'm one of the brothers and sisters. I go take out the trash, whatever it takes. You know, it's no job too big, too small for me. It doesn't bother me. But I would love for this thing here to go on. I mean, decades after decades, it could just go on. And on top of that, dad, grandparents are happy. Dad is happy. He's looking down. And one day, we'll be gone. And it's still going, you know. But again, it's all about building that, continue to have that This Is It team. That's the most important thing, man. It's having that team. And everybody got to have that love and that heart for This Is It, though. You can't just work here. You got to have that love. And you want to run it like it's yours. Like, yes, I want everything to be in the right position, because that's how dad will want it.
In the next 60 years, I plan on seeing This Is It in every major city in the South. It's just always been a goal of mine to expand it as much as I can. I feel like we're sitting on a gold mine, and it's, you know, it just needs to be cultivated right now. You know, we have a good product. You know, we have a good process and good systems of how we do things. At this point, I believe it's time to branch out and, you know, try something new for This Is It. And I think that the things that we have going right now are definitely impactful steps to get us to where we need to be. I truly believe that in the next 60 years, This Is It will be in every major city in the South. Mark my words.
If Sydney and Skylar want to be entrepreneurs in the food business, and they have the desire, the tools, the passion, I'll give them the support. I will not force anything upon them. This Is It was not forced upon me.
To Sydney, I want to tell her to please just stay on top of Christopher, because he's going to be hard to stay on top of. I mean, he's the older cousin, but she's going to be the one to actually keep him in line and make sure that he keeps pushing. I don't want her to let him sway away from what he's doing wrong. I want him to start doing the right thing and stay on the right track every time.
I hope the kids are able to do something. I don't know what. Do something to enable them not to have to work as hard as we had to work. That will not require them to spend so many hours here at the restaurant, because you lose so much of your home life when you do that. And that's something that was always important to me. I always wanted to be at home with my children when I had kids, you know. Unfortunately, I was not able to do that in the latter part of their lives, and now I can. So, you know, I'm a full-time grandmother, you know. So I don't know what direction they want to go, but whatever it is, I hope they figure out a way to just not work as hard, to let their money work for them somehow, so that they can have a better family life.
The thing have lived on this, have been established on these many years because of the food, how good the food is. And I think them coming in, not coming in changing the basic thing that got this establishment exactly where it is today. But don't change that part of it, but if you want to, you can add on different things. And I think that's what they're doing, because of the day and time, things are different. So you do have to take some steps, my opinion, take some type of step to add on to what's already been set up and already finalized. I hear a lot of compliments from customers that comes in. They love this place because they love this location. They love to come here because of the cleanliness of the place and the tasting of the food.
Junior, he's doing good. But y'all got to step up to the plate too. You and your husband, spouses, and brothers, and show them that y'all strong, just strong as they are.
But it's nothing wrong with adding some old to the new. And if Jessica and Thad, her husband, and her brother Chris can, and Craig Jr. can continue to follow their example, the grandparents and their parents, follow the example, follow it. You know, a map is made for a reason, for you to follow it, to get you to a certain destination. If they follow that map, along the way, they're gonna do things a little different, but just follow that map.
I'm really proud of my husband and my children for what they've done. I'm appreciative to my mother-in-law for all the contributions that she made, you know, when she worked with us. She was instrumental in a lot of things, you know, in keeping things going. My husband today still works very hard. If the kids need him for anything, he's here. If anything happens, he's here. Like he says, you know, if you cut him, this is it, pops out, you know.
Honestly, what I would tell, you know, little Chris and, you know, my daughter Sydney and any of the other future kids that might be coming down the line, is to cherish what you have. Obviously, you know, if this is something that you guys want, we're gonna be open arms. We're willing to give it to you. But if we give it to you, cherish it. Don't take it for granted, because it's been a lot of hard work, blood, sweat, and tears that's been put into this business and this restaurant. And you know, just don't take it for granted. I think that would be my biggest thing, because we're gonna set y'all up. You know, just don't take it for granted.
Just begin. Can't stop me now. another girl, the only other child.